If you think review papers are the easy route, think again. Here's the harsh truth. Review articles are harder to get accepted than research papers. Sure, it might come together faster, no months or years spent on data collection, but if you don't get them right, you could find yourself stuck in an endless cycle of rejections, spending years just to get one accepted by a reputable journal. So why do so many bright researchers get trapped here? And more importantly, how can you avoid being one of them? Don't get me wrong, I publish review articles every year, and they are some of the most powerful pieces of work in my entire portfolio. In fact, my review papers are among the highest cited items on my profile, and they have played a huge role in boosting my H index. Take this, for example, published less than a year ago and already sitting at 22 citations. That single paper didn't just raise my citation count, it boosted my visibility, strengthened my positioning in the field, and opened doors that I couldn't have predicted. Invitations, collaborations, paid consultancy, and opportunities I never saw coming. That's the real superpower of a high-quality review articles. They are citation magnets, and if you know how to get them accepted in top journals, then you can completely transform your academic profile. And today, I'm going to walk you through the exact steps you need to take to make your review articles stand out and get accepted by the most competitive journals in your field. Stick with me till the end because I'll show you a real example we used in my recent paper. And if you are ready to level up your publication game, give this video a like and hit the subscribe button. Don't forget the bell so you'll be the first to know when I share more strategies for top-tier journal publication and building a high-impact citation record. Let's get started. If you want to make the right impression with top journals, you must base your work on reviewing articles that come from credible scientific databases. Here is the danger. If you pull your references from unreliable sources or worse, depend on AI generation suggestions that may be nothing more than hallucinations, you are setting yourself up for a massive failure before you've even begun. A solid literature review starts with a solid data extraction. That means relying on databases that are relevant to your field. There are many options, Scopus, Web of Science, PubMed, EBSCO, IEEE, and more. As a side note, a database is neither a journal nor a publisher. It's a search and indexing platform that simply stores, organizes, and makes published content discoverable. Scopus is the largest, most widely available with Web of Science as a strong complement. For discipline-specific research, you might choose PubMed for medical sciences, for instance, IEEE for engineering, and EBSCO for social sciences and humanities. When aiming for top journals, extract your data systematically. And here's a pro tip. Use at least 3 databases. I say this based on experience. Top journals will immediately convince if they see you're standing on solid ground. Besides, in sciences, 3 is the magic number. It's the minimum you need to create reliable statistics, and it signals the reviewers that you've done your homework thoroughly. So start with 3 solid databases and you're already building a strong foundation for acceptance. By the way, if you need a breakdown of the steps you need to take to form a solid literature review paper, drop the word review in the comment section below and I'll send you a guide to show you the step-by-step of the process. Now that you've chosen the right database for your search, my second and most important advice is this: always use a systematic method of searching. This is one of the most important techniques in academic research because it allows you to extract data in a non-biased way and build a fully inclusive discussion around the existing literature on your topic. This step is absolutely crucial if you're aiming for high-quality journals, especially Q1, Q2. Why? Because reviewers and editors will always look into your search strategy. If it's a narrative search, randomly typing keywords into Google Scholar and picking whatever comes your way, you won't leave a strong impression. But if they see that you followed a systematic search process, it makes a huge difference. It signals rigor, credibility, and professionalism. And once you learn how to conduct a systematic literature review, I promise, you would never want to go back. In fact, I recommend applying the systematic search approach even when you're writing research articles. Why? Because every solid study needs a strong background and a clear understanding of the state of the art. And the only reliable way to get that is through systematic search. The next step is to narrow down your search with the right set of keywords. The keywords should not only make sense to your research, but also to the scientific community active in the field. So when you're choosing them, think carefully. How does the scientific community usually refer to this topic? Are there singular and plural forms you should actually include? What alternative terms or abbreviations are commonly used? The more inclusive and precise your keyword selection, the more likely you will land on the right set of results for your literature review. Now, once you've got your keywords, you need to decide how far back in time to search. There are a few strategies here. If there hasn't been a major review in your area yet, start broad. Look at the past 10 years to build a strong foundational discussion. If there are review papers already, then narrow down. See when the last major update was published, and if it was, say, 5 years ago, you can create an updated version of it. If you want to write a very focused mini review, looking at the past 3 to 5 years is often enough. But if you find a review that has been published within the past 1 to 2 years, then there is no point in duplicating that work. In that case, you either want to tweak your focus, shift the angle, or look for a fresh perspective that hasn't been covered yet. That's how you make sure your review paper isn't just yet another paper, but it's a valuable and timely contribution that stands out. From this point onward, I highly recommend you structuring your review using the PRISMA methodology, which stands for Preferred Reporting Items for Systematic Review and Meta-Analysis. PRISMA is one of the most powerful techniques you can use. Why? Because it gives your work a clear, transparent structure that makes it very hard for journals to reject. Here is how it works. You start with the initial search results using the right set of keywords, like I just mentioned. Then you narrow the time range, for example, the past 5 to 10 years, depending on your focus. Next, you decide on the types of articles you will include: research articles, review articles, case studies, or others. Typically, you would want to exclude books and book chapters, or even conference proceedings, and only include research and review articles in your extracted database. Then you will filter by language, document type, and full text availability. Finally, you'll apply inclusion and exclusion criteria that fit your specific angle of study. This step-by-step process helps you systematically filter down thousands of search results into a precise, high-quality set of articles that directly relate to your topic of interest. The beauty of PRISMA is that it's not just organized, it's highly selective. Reviewers love it because it shows that your work is engineered with precision and built on the strongest possible foundation of literature. My team and I have published a number of strong review articles, and I can tell you with full confidence, every time we used the PRISMA methodology and relied on multiple databases, the results spoke for themselves. That's the power of combining systematic method like PRISMA with data pulled from more than one trusted databases. It creates a level of rigor that reviewers and editors can't ignore. Let me show you an example of PRISMA to make things completely clear. Imagine you are trying to understand how emotions affect teaching and learning outcomes. Here's how we cracked it. We conducted a comprehensive literature review on biomarkers within the human body that correlate with emotions. The goal was to understand how emotions can influence teaching and learning outcomes. Here is how we applied the PRISMA. Keyword search. We started with a set of well-chosen keywords and ran a systematic search across multiple databases. For simplicity, let's just focus on Scopus here. Initial screening. Over a 10-year window, we found 243 articles. Full text availability, of these, 5 articles were excluded because the full text weren't available, leaving us with 238 articles. Article type filter, we only included original research and review articles. That meant books, book chapters, editorial notes, conference proceedings were excluded, removing 31 articles from the pool. Human studies only. Since our focus was on human biology, 14 animal studies were excluded. We also removed 12 inconclusive papers that didn't align with the objectives of our work. Biological marker focus. The last filter was the most important. We kept only studies that measured primary biological markers of emotion. Papers that focused on other physical manifestations such as temperature change or heart rate were excluded. This last step removed 83 articles from the pool. In the end, we were left with 98 high-quality articles to analyze and include in our lit review. Our task then was to carefully examine these studies and draw powerful conclusions about the link between biological markers and emotions, and ultimately how emotions impact learning outcomes. While PRISMA can look like a complicated method, it's extremely powerful and puts the journals immediately in your favor. If you're stuck in your lit review, drop review in the comment section below and I'll send you a full guide to get this step figured out without trouble. I'll only send this to the first 50 people who comment review below. And of course, if you're ready to step up to build a complete strategy for getting published in top journals and building a visible research career, then book a free strategy call with me. I dropped the link in the description of this video and I look forward to chatting with you.